Greetings, subscribers, viewers, ladies and germs. Today, we are going to learn how to change the CVT belt on this little 150cc scooter of mine. You go in here and grab the other belt. Show you what the belt looks like. This is the new belt. Little close up of it there. And right there is a series of two, actually it's three numbers. It'd be 842-2030. But this is in fact the right belt for this particular model. So let's get started. Okay, people. I've taken the liberty of loosening up this little body panel here on the 150 of the 150cc scooters of this type of configuration, which this bike you've seen a million times on my YouTube page. You're going to have to loosen that up a little bit in order to get this cover off. Okay. So now what we're going to do is there's a series close-up mode here of bolts on the outside of this cover. See one back there. Then we come down, you got one up in there, you got two right here. Now these two here also have a guard on it that keeps the kickstand from going up onto the cover. So you'll need to make sure that you, all right bug, get out of here, I'm trying to film here. You need to make sure that, little bastard, anyway. Need to make sure that you put that guard back on right there when you're done filming. And then you come around. Now when you get to this area right here, make sure that you get the right bolts. Don't take off the area there, the bolt for the area where you put the gear oil in. You don't want to open that up. Just the bolts for the cover. Okay, now I'm going to put the camera back on the tripod and I'm going to loosen those bolts. Oh, and one other thing, you're going to have to take the kickstand off, which is very simple. All you have to do is just loosen that nut right there and the kickstand will slide right off. So I'm going to put this thing down and do all that and get back to you. Okay, I've got all the bolts off, and by the way, if you're getting any background noise from my neighbor down the way here, I apologize in advance. Normally I try to do these videos on a weekday when everybody's at work, but it's a Sunday, and of course, as soon as I bring my camera out, everybody has to do their yard work. So anyway, we're going to take the old camera off the tripod here. It's almost as if they sit out and wait, look out the windows and wait to see me pull my camera out. Okay, you can see all the bolts are off, and as you can also see, I have them arranged in order. I highly recommend you do this, especially for people like me that are absent-minded. You can see our kickstand is right over here with the bolt that goes with it. Now I'm going to attempt to take this thing off one-handed, which it should come off because I've had it off before. If you're doing it for the first time, there is a gasket that is around the diameter of the cover. It's the gasket is a waste. You don't need it. So when it comes apart after you pull the cover off for the first time, just throw it in the trash. Okay, let's see if we can get this thing off one-handed. Now, look there. Now you can see why I loosened up that area there. Because it wants to hang up right in there. I'm going to put the camera down for a second so I can get two hands on it. So I apologize here for a second. It'll only take a minute. Again, sorry about the camera shake. Okay. Here we go. Now, you can see, I'm going to put us in close up here for a second, that my old belt's in pretty decent shape. But the, come on, autofocus. Okay, you can see the three numbers there that give the belt size. Now, the reason why I'm changing this now is because I want to change it before it breaks, not after. Because once the belt breaks, it's not just going to break as if you took a pair of scissors and cut it. It's going to disintegrate. And then you will never get that number. So, now what we're going to do here, you can see the clutch, if I can do it one-handed, you can squeeze this and it's going to come together. Okay, again, I'm going to put the camera down for a second so I can get it started so I can show you. So bear with me here. Okay, I'm going to have to put the camera. I'm not going to be able to show you how to do that one-handed. So I'm going to go get the tripod and we're going to zero in on that area. So we're going to stop the camera for a second. And I'm going to mount it up so you can see what I'm talking about. Okay, we got a pretty good camera position on this baby here, so I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. Watch closely. You see that? When I'm squeezing that, the belt is loosening up. Now, obviously, I'm not going to be able to hold this and take the belt off at the same time. So, but you get the general idea. And then you're going to take your belt and take it off from this pulley over here on this side. You could probably do it on this side here too. I just prefer to do it over here because this, as opposed to this being, this will move, this is stationary as far as going back and forth this way. And also, I'm going to take a C-clamp and I'm going to C-clamp that shut so I can work with both hands. Okay. So we're going to stop right there. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, there it is. The new belt is now on. I'm going to have to be truthful, though, in the interest of full disclosure. When I took my hand and collapsed this, there still wasn't enough slack, in true Chinese scooter fashion, of course, to get the belt off. So what I had to do is I had to remove the bolt here from this drive pulley and take this part of the pulley off, and then the belt obviously just came right off. So let this be a lesson to you, because to get that bolt off, I had to use a compressor and an impact wrench. And the reason why that is because you're not going to be able to get enough bite just doing it with your arm, because this turns. Okay? So, the moral of the story here is, boys and girls, don't attempt this unless you know what you're doing and have the proper tools. Okay? That pretty much wraps up our CVT automatic transmission belt change. One quick thing though, if your belt does happen to come apart inside the housing here, you need to either get some air from a compressor and just take your compressed air and just squirt everything out of there, because you're also going to have pieces of belt inside the cover too. For those lacking a good air compressor, and really if you don't have an air compressor, you shouldn't be attempting this particular maintenance job on a Chinese style 150cc scooter. You should take it to someone who has the proper equipment. But in any event, if it breaks inside there, you're gonna have pieces of belt everywhere, and you're gonna need to air blow that stuff out with either, like I stated, an air compressor or some of that canned compressed air that you buy for computers. So, like I said, that's pretty much it for our CVT transmission job here. I'm going to put the cover back on. And it's about 93 degrees in the shade out here, so we're going to call it a day. Till then, next time I'll show you how to adjust the idle on one of these babies. So from the Twisted Piston Garage, I bid you a fond farewell.